JFT Just Fair and Direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's Daily Market Review for January the 12th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, Senior Market Analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against all the other G10 currencies on Friday, Monday, and during the Asian morning Tuesday. It gained the most against SEK, NOK, NZD, and AUD in that order, while it eked out the least gains versus the pound and the Japanese yen. The strengthening of the US dollar and the yen, combined with the weakening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi, suggests that the markets traded in a risk-off fashion. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that major EU and US indices were a sea of red, with the EU ones pulling back from over 10-month highs and Wall Street retreating from record levels. Investors' appetite improved somewhat during the Asian session today. Although South Korea's KOSPI slid 0.71%, Japan's Nikkei 225, China's Shanghai Composite, and Hong Kong's Hang Seng rose 0.09, 2.18, and 0.94% respectively. According to media reports, the slide in riskier assets may have been the result of surging coronavirus cases around the globe, which surpassed 90 million on Monday. What's more, daily cases hit new records in the end of last week, while yesterday China saw its biggest daily increase in infections in more than 5 months. Another factor that may have weighed on the broader market sentiment may have been worries that any fresh fiscal stimulus in the US may be delayed as House Democrats introduced a resolution to impeach US President Trump, accusing him of inciting insurrection following a violent attack on the Capitol by his supporters. As for our view, all this may have been an excuse for investors to lock profits following the latest steep rally in equities. We still believe that the vaccinations, the fiscal stimulus in the US, and the monetary policy support around the globe are likely to continue providing support for risk-linked assets. Thus, we would treat the current retreat as a corrective move before the next leg north. Now, in the currency world, apart from safe haven inflows, the US dollar may have also received support from the recent spike in US Treasury yields, with the spread between the 2-year and 10-year yields widening the most since July 2017. However, we believe that the rapidly widening twin deficit in the US may keep any USD recovery limited. The explosion in the budget and trade deficits means that more dollars are being printed and move abroad. So with President-elect Joe Biden pledged to provide more fiscal support, meaning that the nation's debt will increase, the dollar is likely to remain under selling interest in the first months of 2021. Now, as for today's events, the calendar appears very light today. We only get the US JOLTS job openings for November and the American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week. No forecast is available for neither release. As for the speakers, we have five on today's agenda. Those are Atlanta Fed President Raphael Bostic, Dallas Fed President Robert Kaplan, Cleveland Fed President Loretta Mester, Kansas City Fed President Esther George, and Fed Board Governor Lyle Brainard. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.